All right, listen, are there things in the back of your mind that you know you should be doing right now? And are these things in the back of your mind because you convince yourself, you know what, I can always do them later?
Yeah, man, I can play one more. Let's finish on a win before I start this project.
And then you hit one of those Rocket League losing streaks where it's always your teammates' fault, right? Or the game just continuously gives you bad teammates.
Really, what a save. What about that shot you whiffed 3 plays ago?
Just one more game turns into hours, and then you're rushing to meet a deadline or simply get things done around your house that you've been putting off. Or maybe you're watching this YouTube video because you're stuck in the continuous pull of the YouTube algorithm, recommending video after video after video, keeping your attention as long as possible. Well, maybe this is one video that you want to watch, because I'm going to show you how to stop procrastinating in just 5 steps and get things done way before deadlines. So you're not staying up until 4 a.m., drinking an insane amount of coffee, and falling asleep at your desk. These steps will help you stop lying to yourself and convincing yourself, you know what, I'll just finish it tomorrow. I've missed trash day in my city numerous times because I always convince myself that I'll take the trash cans down to the end of the road after dinner. Then of course it slips my mind and I struggle to close the lid down for another week. In my defense, I live in the country and my driveway is about 0.3 miles long. However, that doesn't excuse my procrastination. Or if you follow my freelance content, then maybe you've been putting off learning a new skill. I know this is something that really hits home for me. How can I stay focused and stop procrastinating is one of the most frequent questions that I get on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, you get the point. Procrastination is a struggle that most people battle with constantly. These 5 steps helped me tremendously in my career as one of the top earning freelancers on Upwork, and I hope they can help you as well. Let's get started. How many times have you heard, make a list of what you need to get done? In videos on how to stop procrastinating or motivation videos on how to get more done, I've personally heard it numerous times. But what if you have a massive project that could take a month or even longer? For example, when writing scripts for my YouTube videos, that's something that takes hours between researching, planning, and writing. Having a task written down that says write YouTube script is something that I procrastinate on because I start thinking about all the work involved and then I talk myself out of it. You see, that's the problem with writing down what you want to get done. If the overall task is daunting due to the hours of work involved, then that tends to lead to procrastination. So the way to counter this is to break your task down into smaller, actionable tasks that you will complete working towards the bigger picture. For example, if I create a task to create a new YouTube video, I start thinking about all the subtasks within the main task. I need to research a topic, create a title, write a script breaking everything out into sections, film the video. You see, there's a lot of steps involved. A better approach would be to create a smaller, more actionable task, such as research topic and create title. I'm more likely to complete that task in the same day because my focus is more narrowed and I'm not thinking about everything else that I need to do as well. The great thing about creating a daily list of actionable items is that once you finish them, then you can reward yourself. For example, after I complete my 5 critical tasks for the day, I often spend time with my fiance, relax in our hot tub, or play video games. I can fully enjoy those things without the overwhelming task in the back of my mind, reminding myself that I procrastinated all day. This involves making a shift to focus on production rather than hours. It doesn't matter how many hours you sit in front of a computer at your desk all day or whatever your job may be. What you get done and accomplish in the day is what matters. I actually learned about this from Andy Frisella's MFCEO podcast. In the podcast, he mentions the power list. This involves creating a daily list of 5 critical tasks that you will complete no matter what. After you complete them, you can choose to get more work done or do whatever you want.
But basically the way it works is this. I pick 5 tasks, okay? Just 5, not 6, not 7, not 10. And they're 5 critical tasks that I have to get done for my day to count as a win. All right, and now all those 5 tasks are not all business related, by the way.
As you heard Andy say, your 5 tasks don't all have to be business related. So for example, here's 5 critical tasks that I would do on a given day. Number 1, work out for 30 minutes. Number 2, research a topic for a new YouTube video. Number 3, schedule meetings with Upwork clients. Number 4, do a load of laundry. And number 5, send out invoices to clients. A really simple task for you could be to hit the like button on this video and consider subscribing to the channel. The point is to keep your task broken down, simple enough and concise enough to finish in a day. They may be subtasks of a much larger task or project, but by keeping them granular, you're less likely to feel overwhelmed and procrastinate. As I mentioned earlier, if you're a freelancer like myself, one of your daily actionable tasks could be simply sending out invoices to clients. And this is actually a great task because it involves you getting paid.
And now a word from our sponsor.
Whether your goal is to be a database administrator, database developer, or you just want to learn a new skill, SQL Server can be a very lucrative career. I personally earn over $200,000 a year with my SQL Server and database skill set. As a freelancer, it's so important to have tools that make your life easier and allow you to focus on your work. If you're like me, everything about invoicing is a hassle. Creating invoices, sending them out, tracking who paid and who didn't, it can be stressful to say the least. This is where our sponsor, Invoice Ninja, can help. They have gorgeous mobile apps. I can make and send out invoices in seconds, track who's viewing them, and of course, get paid for my hard work. As an extremely busy freelancer, Invoice Ninja allows me to focus on the work that I love and makes the invoicing process so much easier. They have a free version and paid versions as well, so head to the first link in the description of this video to find the best solution for you. Thank you so much to Invoice Ninja for supporting the channel and sponsoring this video. Also, if you could take a second and destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm, I would sincerely appreciate it. It helps my channel out tremendously.
The next step is one that's had a huge impact on my productivity and my self-learning as well. The Pomodoro technique was invented in the early 1990s by Francesco Cirillo. Now there's a decent chance that you already heard about this technique because it's very popular. Francesco Cirillo was struggling to focus on his studies and complete assignments. Feeling overwhelmed, he asked himself to commit to just 10 minutes of focused study time. Encouraged by the challenge, he found a tomato, which is Pomodoro in Italian, shaped kitchen timer, and the Pomodoro technique was born. This technique not only helps prevent myself from procrastinating, but it also immensely increases my focused effort as well. First, pick one specific task that you need to work on. The key word is one. The goal is to have complete focused effort on a single task rather than trying to multitask, which can lead to you feeling overwhelmed and procrastinating. An example of this for me would be to work on writing a script for a YouTube video. Next, set a timer for 25 minutes. You can use an iPhone timer, Alexa, or even Pomodoro apps. Alexa, set a timer for 25 minutes.
25 minutes, starting now.
There's tons of Pomodoro apps out there, but I personally use the Focus Keeper time management app. It's simple to use, has a great interface, and it's been really helpful. Once a timer starts, work as hard as possible on that single task while avoiding multitasking. Put all your focused effort into the task, knowing that when the timer ends, you'll be rewarded and feel great about your effort as well. If for any reason you become distracted during the 25 minutes of work, write down the distraction and save it for later. Once your session ends, mark off one Pomodoro and take a 5-minute break. And if you're using a Pomodoro app like Focus Keeper, it manages all this for you. After your 5-minute break ends, repeat the same process 3 more times. After 4 Pomodoro sessions, take a longer, more restorative 15 to 30 minute break. Then repeat the same process over and over and over and over until you've completed all your tasks. I love how the Pomodoro technique is so simple, but has such a large impact on my productivity. So in the first step, we discussed how you need to create a daily list of 5 critical tasks. And now we are using the Pomodoro technique to complete the 5 critical tasks. Studies have shown that an effective way to break out of the avoidance cycle is to shrink down whatever you've been putting off into a tiny, unintimidating first step. Procrastinating doesn't necessarily mean that you're being lazy or that you lack discipline. We actually put off things to avoid negative feelings, such as feeling overwhelmed. For example, when I think about the SQL Server course that I need to create, I think about all the planning I need to do and all the videos I need to film, which coincidentally causes me to feel overwhelmed and procrastinate. Now, jumping back to the 5 critical tasks and utilizing the Pomodoro technique, I can simply write down film course introduction. This task is smaller and more focused as well. My mind can be hyper-focused on the single task and tune out all the other insane amounts of work that I need to do. The Pomodoro technique has been immensely valuable to me and helps me simply accomplish more things in my day. I'm able to actively make progress rather than being stuck in the start phase for months or even years. The third step is one of the most important steps to really help focus in on your work, which is removing distractions. The first thing I do is move my phone away from me, keeping it close enough where I can see my Pomodoro timer, but far enough away where I won't be tempted to open social media apps, check YouTube comments, or check how close I am to completing my weekly learning goal on Pluralsight. By the way, there are free trial links in the description of this video for both Skillshare and Pluralsight as well. They're two of my favorite platforms to learn new freelance skills and enhance my existing skill set. Be sure to check those out in the description box of this video and enjoy the free trials as well. Anyway, my phone is always my number one distraction. The less I pick up my phone and get sucked into apps, the more work I get done. The Pomodoro app that I use really helps a lot because my screen constantly stays on, which prevents me from tapping my screen over and over to see if I've had a notification. I love working from home and I'm way more productive in my home workspace. But if you work from home like I do, then you know about all the other distractions that can arise. If you have kids, pets, or other people in your home, then the distractions can come from a vast variety of areas. It's important to set working hours and let people know when you can't be interrupted. Working from home gives you the ultimate flexibility, which is amazing. But unless you're living alone, then you need to set expectations. If you're constantly being interrupted, then you won't be able to establish a consistent flow of work. Let them know that after you complete 4 iterations of 25-minute sprints or 4 Pomodoros, then you'll have a longer break. It's all about communication and setting expectations. The goal is to optimize your workspace and remove anything that could distract you. Clean off your workspace and be sure to close anything on your computer that could distract you as well. Remember that when using the Pomodoro technique, you really need to focus on one task at a time. Only have tabs or applications open that are specific to the task to prevent you from being sidetracked. Going back to the Pomodoro technique, if you think about something that you need to do, then just write it down so you can revisit it later. Don't let it immediately pull you away. Write it down and check the list later during a break. Some of my biggest procrastination triggers are checking email, checking YouTube analytics or comments, and checking social media. The goal of removing distractions is to prevent these triggers from occurring. I also find that listening to lo-fi beats helps with my mood, my productivity, and helps me remove distractions as well. The beats are so calming and relaxing to listen to. Unlike listening to music with words, with lo-fi beats, I can listen to the music without having to think about what I'm listening to. I love them so much that I actually created a lo-fi beats playlist YouTube video with some of my favorite music. I worked with an extremely talented artist who created the illustration and the animations for the video. It shows me working at my desk with all my animals and farm outside my window. It brings such a peaceful and calming vibe to my day, and I often leave it open all day long as I'm working. I'll throw a card above that you can click on to check out the lo-fi beats playlist. And of course, it'll be linked in the description of this video as well. The fourth step is to surround yourself with people who inspire you and bring out the best in you. This is such a critical step that often gets overlooked. It gets so frequently overlooked because we often overlook negative traits and try to see the best in people who are close to. This is something that affected me for such a long time, and I had to make some really difficult decisions. There's certain people who I was really close to that I cut out of my life. At the end of the day, those relationships were only bringing negativity to my life, and they were holding me back in so many ways. Removing those people from my life were honestly some of the most difficult decisions that I've ever had to make. But I'm honestly so much happier now, and my success has increased dramatically. The one and only Tony Robbins describes this perfectly. He said, "The only thing that will change your life, change your business, change your relationship, is that you must raise your standards. Get rid of negative people who bring you down. Surround yourself with people who lift you up, lend you knowledge, and help you learn from your mistakes. Raise your standards for your inner circle." If you surround yourself with people who have similar aspirations or ambitions as you, then it will motivate you to work harder. Your mood will be more positive, and tying into the last step, it'll help remove distractions. Let me know in the comments section if you can relate to this. I've personally had people in my life who were so negative and made me feel so bad about myself that I constantly thought about it. I couldn't establish a consistent flow of work, and it led to immense procrastination. Now I'm surrounded with people who inspire me and push me every single day. It all starts with your closest relationship. My fiance is honestly the best person I've ever met. She's so selfless and supports all of my dreams and ambitions. In my opinion, you either need someone like her in your life or no one at all. If you're with someone who's always negative and doesn't support your dreams, then you're always going to be held back by them. Don't wait until later in life when you're filled with regret because you never went after what you want. You get one life, so make the most of it. Surround yourself with good people who want the best for you and uplift you. This video from Will Smith really hit home for me. It was really helpful for me to hear when I was going through one of the most difficult times in my life, and I hope that it helps you as well.
The prerequisite for spending time with any person is that they nourish and inspire you. They feed your flame. Look at your last 5 text messages. Are those people feeding your flames or dousing your fire? Put your phone down for just a second and look around. Look to the people around you. Are those people throwing logs on your fire or are they pissing on it? The people that you spend time with are gonna make or break your dreams. Everybody don't deserve to be around you. You gotta defend your light with your life.
The 5th step to stop procrastinating is to visualize the positive outcome. Most people aren't aware of how powerful that visualizing can be in their lives. We visualize things frequently every single day, but the type of visualizations that we do can either have a positive or a negative impact on our lives. Think of a really difficult task or project that you need to do. When you think about the task, are you thinking about how difficult that the work will be or how rewarding that it's going to feel when you complete it? The issue is that most of us think about the worst outcomes and all the difficulties rather than focusing on the positive outcome. For example, when working with a new freelance client, I focus on providing the most value to them. I know that if I provide tons of value and I help them, then likely I'm going to get a 5-star review. I visualize receiving the 5-star review, great feedback, and the potential for long-term work. If I focused on the worst possible outcome, such as receiving a bad review, then it would negatively impact my production. Research has also found that people who imagine themselves performing a task improve their performance in the task. When starting one of your 5 critical tasks, visualize the positive outcome of completing the task. Think about how completing the task will move you forward in your business, your life, or personal development. Manifestation has been a huge thing for me on Upwork. When starting out on Upwork, I kept visualizing how it would feel to reach $50,000 earned, $100,000, $500,000, and so on. When learning a new skill, I visualize how the knowledge will make me more valuable. Start visualizing the positive outcome of whatever you're doing. If you constantly visualize negative outcomes and negative emotions from doing the work, then you will continuously put it off and procrastinate. The human mind is such a powerful thing. The more you visualize where you want to be, the harder that you're going to push yourself to get there. Additionally, something else that wasn't in the 5 steps, but should be obvious, is to take care of yourself. Be sure to get enough sleep, exercise consistently, and eat a healthy diet. All of those things will improve how you feel during the day, which will lead to you being more productive. I know for me personally that when I'm extremely tired, it's so easy for me to procrastinate. I constantly just think about how tired I am, which makes it so difficult to focus. When I get around 7 to 8 hours of sleep, I just feel so much more motivated and focused during the day. My most productive days are when I complete 4 rounds of Pomodoros, get a 30-minute workout in, and then just cycle through Pomodoros the rest of the day. The most important takeaway from this entire video is to start today. Start implementing the steps from this video now. Don't procrastinate and wait until tomorrow or next week. I know you're thinking about it right now. It's time for you to take control of your life and go after what you want. Don't wait around and be filled with regret later in life. Don't sit around procrastinating, thinking, you know what, I'm going to start tomorrow. Today just isn't a good day for me. I can always start tomorrow. When you're doing that, someone else is actually putting in the work and putting in the grind to accomplish the things that you want in life. You only get one life, so make it count. If my content helps you and you get value from it, be sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I post freelancing tips, personal development tips, and just glimpses into my workday on those platforms every single day. And again, if you're in the process of learning a new skill or enhancing an existing skill set, then check out the links in the description of this video for free trials of Skillshare and Pluralsight. And again, I want to thank InvoiceNinja.com for sponsoring today's video. If you're like me, you really don't like the paperwork. So if you'd rather focus on your passion and not waste time on the administration stuff, then check out Invoice Ninja by clicking on the first link in the description of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Put in the work, put in the grind, be consistent on a daily basis, and let's get to work.
On this end screen, I recommend checking out these videos, and be sure to hit that round subscribe button for weekly tech videos, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss anything. Thank you for watching, and until next time.